Hello guys, welcome to my channel. My name is Ricardo Sims. For those of you joining me for the very first time, welcome to my OGs. I do hope you're having a blessed day. So consider subscribing. Today I want to talk about a very important topic. You know, I've been getting a lot of questions in regards to this topic, and I decided to make a video. Actually, the Lord has given me a word that I wrote down that I'm going to be reading from my book to you all, and I also will be giving you the insight based on experience, lived experience. So again, my name is Ricardo, and I'm just going to give you a backdrop of my story. I won't get into too much of it, but this has a linking. My story has a linking with today's topic, and that's ministering to the LGBTQ community without compromising. You know, a lot of people ask this question: how do you minister to this group of people without compromising the word of God, without offending anyone? So I wanted to share what the Lord has basically, you know, given me, you know, to say to you all, and I also would like to share my basically my experience. Okay, so for 30 years of my life, I believed I was a boy trapped in a girl's body. I later transitioned into female, and I was living my life, you know, and I had an encounter with God, and God transformed my life. And here I am today as a man of God, a minister of the gospel, here to share the love of God that led me to repentance. So I'm going to link my video somewhere here or here, and you can go to watch that testimony to fully understand, you know, my story better. But, you know, for those of you who have been asking me in the comment section, how do you minister to the LGBTQ community without compromising? So this morning in prayer, the Lord told me to write all this down. So I'll be reading from this, and then I'll be giving you my input. So the only place that can deliver anyone from this great stronghold desire is the cross. The cross is powerful for all circumstances. There's no power of the enemy that can stand against the cross. Jesus didn't just defeat death, but sin, and all sin at that. Now watch this. The enemy grooms and convinces the young minds of our children to believe that there's no way out for them, and this was the way God created them. Now back to the cross. The enemy knows that the cross is the only thing that can break his lies and deception. So what does he do? He tells the LGBTQ community that God hates them and they are an abomination unto him, which is a big fat lie from the pit of hell. God hates sin indeed because he's holy and righteous, but not the sinner. Remember, the only place that can defeat this lie is the cross. Now watch this. The enemy plants the lie that God hates them, and some/most Christians waters it. What do I mean by some Christian waters the lies? By the way they approach this sin in particular. As Christians, we're not called to change a sinner, but witness to them about the goodness of God. We can't change people. Only God can. You shouldn't force, manipulate, or threaten anyone to serve God. Witchcraft. Another story for another time. But when a gay person has an encounter with a Christian, it's mostly about them being condemned to hell. Repent, you're going to hell. That's the first thing a lot of Christian utters out of their mouth towards the LGBTQ community. Are them feeling like a project needed to be worked on urgently? Being cast out of devils and devils being cast out of them, which is unbiblical. As shown in Jesus' ministry, he always asked the sinner, do you want to be healed? After then, go and say, sin no more. Jesus knows the importance that if a person isn't really ready to leave sin behind, etc., The enemy goes out of that person. If you are quick to lay hands and quick to cast out devils out of people, Jesus knows that if you do that and a person is not ready for that or has not come to light yet as to what this commitment means, and they fall back into sin, what will happen to them is the way you have found them, they're going to be worse. Because in Matthew 12 verse 45, it tells you that, you know, so the enemy goes out of the person seeking a place. And if he doesn't find rest, he comes back with seven more, you know, evil spirit, wickeder than him. So basically, if you just see a person and you're just ready to work on them as a project without any leading by the Holy Spirit, you're putting them at great risk, because they need to know the gospel, because it's only the gospel that can break this stronghold off of somebody's life. Not your desire to work on them, to feel like you've gained a soul. That's not how it works. So don't be quick to lay your hands, according to 1 Timothy 5 verse 22. But share the truth of God's word, which is sharper than any two-edged sword, piercing even to the dividing asunder of the soul and spirit. That is, you know, Hebrews 4 verse 12. The word of God, listen to me, people of God. The word of God is not just ink on paper, but a living word of God that speaks and declares a thing. It speaks and declares a thing in one's life, and so shall it be. The simple answer is sharing the word, not your feelings and opinion. Those are your words, but God's word transforms life. Your word is your word. Why do you think many Christians are filled with, this is a whole nother story, but why do you think a lot of Christians in church are still in bondage and still, you know, in this stagnation in the church? Why do you think that is? Because they have replaced the word of God that holds the power and the authority with motivational speakers and pastors with their own opinions and what they think and all that kind of stuff. That's why a lot of people are not delivered from their struggles. So back to the point. This was God sharing this to you. So your question is, how can you minister to a person from that community without compromising? It is simple. Speak the truth, the word of God. Of course, speak the word of God to them. Tell them the truth. Never compromise what God has spoken in his word to accommodate anybody. Because it's only the word that has the authority and the power to renew a person's mind, to transform a person's life. So when you meet a person like this and you don't know how to approach them, start by just showing them the love of God. Because you see, this community is welcoming. This community is, you know, they embrace one another, no matter how different you are, what size you are, what color you are. They embrace and love each other in that community, and they create this union among themselves. I'm not saying it's perfect, but that's what they do. And that should be the church. But instead, a lot of church feels as if when this person walks through the door, I'm going to take them on immediately as a project. Yes, tell them about the gospel. That's how you can minister to someone. Tell them the truth about God's word, and tell them about the grace and the mercy that God offers to sinners. Not just them, because we're all sinners that fall short for the, you know, for the glory of God. We have all fallen short. We have all fallen short. So you have to let them know that I'm not perfect, I've fallen short, but the mercy and grace of God has redeemed me and restored me, and share your testimony with them. Yes, people should know that if they don't repent, they are going to go to hell. But you have to generalize it that yes, everybody who sins will not inherit the kingdom of God. Not just you, but myself. If tomorrow I should fall into sin and I didn't repent and I live a life of a sinful life, I will not inherit the kingdom of God. Because the enemy plants the lie, and most of us, the way how we treat them and the way how we welcome them, you know, we water that lie within them, that the church is against them because God hates them, because they feel different. They don't feel welcome. They feel like, okay, I need to take you on as a project. We need to change you. We need to lay our hands on you. We need to cast out the demons. No, that's not how it works. Embrace them. Invite them in. Show them the love of God, because this community needs love. They're all seeking for love and acceptance. And the one place that can free them from their struggle is the Christian community. And the enemy has lied to them about what God has spoken over them. And then Christians, with their attitude, how they treat them, you know, the enemy gets a chance to say, you see, I told you, this is how they are against people like you. So stay away from them. So you don't be a person that will offend them to the pits of hell. I'm not telling you to compromise. And I'm not telling you to let them in and welcome them in to be in position of leadership while living in sin. That's not how it works. That's not what I'm saying. I'm saying you have to learn to understand that this stronghold in many people's life, like any other, start from a very young age. And the war between the Christian community and this community is at a high. So the chance of them being saved is very slim. So we have to, it's a very delicate situation. It's a very delicate topic. It's a very delicate situation. But the power of God, ask the Holy Spirit to lead you as to how you can minister to them. So my prayer is that you will, you know, get the wisdom and knowledge of understanding as to how you go about something like this when you encounter a person that is from this community. You get what I'm saying? So I just wanted to leave that with you. And what I shared with you earlier when I was reading is what God gave to me this morning in prayer. And I decided to share it with you. And I just want you to know that we can all minister to them. You don't have to be in the same situation. Sin is sin. And we all need a Savior. So no matter if it's for this situation or for that situation, as long as it's a person who don't know who God is, your sole purpose and your sole job is to witness to them and tell them about the goodness of God, also the wrath of God. But please, do not condemn people to hell. But you have to tell them if they don't repent of their sin, they're going to go to hell. So allow the Holy Spirit to lead you in this situation, in this topic. And until then, I will see y'all again next time in the next video. Do not forget to share this video with someone. And, you know, so somebody can learn how to, you know, minister to somebody, maybe a family member or, you know, whoever the case may be in their lives. So love and embrace that person, but do not compromise the word of God for nobody, not even for yourself, not even for me, not even for your loved ones. All right. So God bless y'all. And I see y'all again. Do not forget to like, share, and subscribe. Until then, God bless.